Today I'm taking an audience request. No, not to stop making this show, but someone on Earth, that's all I have to say about that Facebook group, asked me, can you do an episode on how climate change will change the American economy? Well, sure I can, because we just got a 1,656-page report detailing climate change's economic impacts. Boy, they certainly weren't worried about the trees when they wrote that one. Well, I had to cut down the Amazon to print this thing, but I know nothing will convince the president and the public quite like a nuanced report that's more than 50% longer than War and Peace. I mean, if it's more than 280 characters, good luck. So, what is actually in this report? Well, a bunch of stuff about polluting air leading to respiratory problems and early death. But getting people to worry about the environment because it could kill you? That ship has sailed. Instead, we're here to focus on the other green, cash money.
The government has released a huge report on the impact of climate change, and the findings are dire. Not just for our health and our environment, the way you'd expect it to be, but also for the economy.
Now, before I keep going, this episode is about the effect, not the cause of climate change. So even if you believe it's nature and not man-made, well, it's still changing, so you'll be able to make it through the rest of this episode without putting your fist through your computer. So let's get started. No real surprise, but this is a bit of a daunting task. I mean, this thing is thorough. For the sake of simplicity, I'm gonna break this into a few categories. Death, destruction, and shrinking production capacities. Sounds like a fun episode. First, you know how people say you can't put a price on life? Well, economists said, hold my beer. This next part might be a little sociopathic, so buckle up.
Heat-related deaths to increase, everything from drought to insect-causing diseases like Lyme disease, Zika, West Nile, all of that laid out.
Wow, I think you just named half of the four horsemen by name. This report predicts 9,000 additional premature deaths per year under a higher scenario by the end of the century. Now, that's sad, but how would a sociopath conceive of that? With these deaths, almost 2 billion labor hours are projected to be lost annually by 2090 from the impacts of temperature extremes, costing an estimated $160 billion in lost wages. Turns out, 9,000 additional deaths each year, not great for the economy. The next major loss is, well, I'll put it this way. I'd invest in some real estate that's 30 feet above sea level, because that could soon be beachfront.
Rising sea level costs as high as $118 billion.
Now, clearly, unless you're incredibly optimistic that the future of real estate is barges, you're probably going to be thinking that rising sea levels are not good for the economy. Not only does it objectively just cut down on available real estate, but it increases the size of potential floodplains in the event of an emergency. If you look at the cost predictions for this portion though, it's incredibly contingent on how we adapt. If you look at the graphs, there's an 80% savings if we prepare. And people are taking notes. We're even seeing Mr.
I don't believe it.
Explicitly citing global warming and its consequential increased erosion due to rising sea levels and extreme weather this century as a chief justification for his building a seawall to protect his Scotland golf course. Hey, at least he managed to secure funding for one wall. Now he'll have a dry sand trap to bury his head in when the storms hit. It's this private investment that makes me think we're gonna adapt the majority of our structures to resist flooding. Although, we are seeing Miami do a pretty terrible job dealing with their flooding situation currently. Who would have thought that climate change would affect a city whose major sports team is literally called the Heat? Look out, Seattle Storm!
Flooding emergency along coastal cities today in South Florida as rising tides are leading to flooded streets.
Another night of tidal flooding on Miami.
Florida reportedly has the most number of big cities at risk from rising sea level.
So those are the types of problems that are probably going to be costing us a ton of money in the sea level department. Oh, and speaking of water, the next big cost is agriculture. Specifically, an increased rate of drought in the Midwest. Now, they didn't even bother to try to predict a price on this one, because, as the report says, the good people over at Monsanto are developing new seeds that are drought and heat resistant. So, who knows? This would be like trying to figure out the impact of a horse shortage on transportation while Ford was working on his first car. My God, by the year 1950, only 10% of the population will have access to horse-drawn carriages. What we can see, though, is examples. Like in 2012, the United States experienced a severe and extensive drought, with more than two-thirds of its counties declared as disaster areas. And that accounted for $14.5 billion in loss payments by the Federal Crop Insurance Program. Thanks, Obama! An increase in the intensity and number of these would-be droughts would be expensive. Not to mention, lack of food and water is not a great combination for survival. These droughts are also linked to...
Two fires have destroyed more than 150 homes in the foothills and canyons outside of Los Angeles.
And when you destroy homes, well, someone's paying to rebuild them. Lastly, infrastructure. Because you remember Infrastructure Week, the program that crumbled faster than an American bridge. It didn't even last the aforementioned week. Well, it's no secret that the US has some terrible infrastructure. There are some New York City subway stations that rats steer clear of. So, when intensified storm hits and things start to get hotter, the infrastructure really gets messed up. This report says failing to address aging and deteriorating infrastructure is expected to cost US GDP as much as $3.9 trillion by 2025. Again, this is GDP, not any single person or government's budget. So, if because of a messed up road you're an hour late to work, that's coming out of GDP. Or maybe a pebble through the windshield delays a shipment of computers. Millions of these small delays accumulate in the United States producing $4 trillion less in stuff and services than it otherwise would have. Although, it does go far in validating my "I'm sorry, I'm late" train delay excuse. You asked about America's economy. But there are a few economically destructive honorable mentions this report brings up. First,
what happened from 2007 to 2010 in Syria contributed to the unrest that ultimately led to the country plunging into civil war. And that was a major drought.
Not every country can afford Monsanto seeds, as in Syria, between 2008 and 2010, about 2 million Syrian farmers were displaced because they just kind of ran out of water in that country. As we all know, that worked out perfectly for everybody. And, well, it's definitely impacted the US budget quite a bit since then. Secondly,
recent widespread flooding in Thailand is set to bump up the price of computer equipment. The rising waters have wiped out more than a quarter of the world's hard drive production.
While American and other first world nations can protect ourselves either publicly or privately from a lot of this, the countries that make a lot of our stuff can't. So when they experience extreme weathers, our costs go up. All of this accumulates in the horrifying and objectively misleading headline that most news reports ran with.
The U.S. economy could be reduced by 10%.
America's GDP dropping by 10% by the end of the century.
10% of the country's gross domestic product gone by the end of the century.
So, because of climate change, we're going to have our GDP shrink 10% by the end of the century? Well, no, because over that period, our GDP is expected to grow 300%. Don't get me wrong, this still isn't good. The prediction basically says we'll grow by 270% instead of 300% because of climate change. But saying that's shrinking is like saying we're pulling out of Afghanistan because we're only putting in an additional 10,000 troops. So that's how climate change affects the US economy, according to the most recent reports. Remember that this thing was 1,656 pages. So if I missed your favorite destructive climate change cost, which, weird, let me know about it in the comments. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and remember to give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.